Let's see if we can delete an entire squad as they come in. All right, 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, damn! And it's raining helmets. Oh, my goodness gracious me. Hello again, friends and fans. Raptor here. Welcome to the defense of Belgium. German forces are moving through, and Belgian forces here are being alerted that they're on their way. Again, World War I and Battle of Empires with the mod link in the description. Thank you very much for joining me in a Circle 7 to all of those troops who fought in World War I. And speaking of World War I, Battlefield 1 announced as well. Next to your Circle 7, let me know what you're most excited to do in Battlefield 1. Mine, of course, would probably be to hit somebody in the face with an entrenching tool. Bah! And then also to fistfight somebody on a Zeppelin. I hope you can do that. If not, I'm going to be very disappointed. But I won't be disappointed because they've got biplanes. Super excited to be the Rap Baron. All right. Germans have invaded us. We must defend our land. Yes, indeed, we must. All right, so go ahead and let me know then down in the comments section what you think about that World War I game. And we've got a few minutes here to set up defenses. Plenty of territory to defend, too. Plenty of farm fields and a city over there. We're going to get rocking right away. We've got MGs over here. Looks like they're going to attack from the north and the west. So we've got to defend both those positions. Whop on these MGs right away and start utilizing them for our benefit then and set those up in town and outside of town as well. Two positions that we're going to have to set up. Let's get these MGs moving right away then. Plenty of troops for us to use as well. Well, it looks like there's sandbags in the crates that we can use. We should use them. Yes. Definitely. Yes, indeed. All right. Let's get moving. So we've got our troops on the way outside the base. Excellent. Let's go ahead and designate a few men then to set up defensive positions. We've got Lewis guns. We've got awesome carabiners as well. Some of the Belgians looking some of the best. Look at those top hats, man. Those guys come ready for warfare. Look at that. That looks so super cool. Love to see those forces here. All right. So let's go ahead and get set up here. We've got sandbags that we can set up. Looks like we've got artillery that'll arrive in a few minutes as well. All right, let's get those machine guns going. All right, we do not have enough time to set up all the defenses we want to set up, so as soon as the enemy arrives, we'll more than likely be setting up those defenses as well. And make sure, by the way, that before our field artillery gets here, but make sure you turn your mouse into a field artillery and hit that like button with some of that artillery as well. Thank you very much. Hopefully we can get, I think we can get to 550, I think, no problem. So show your support for the Belgians here as about 550, or I actually don't know about the real numbers, but a handful of Belgians defended against 100,000 Germans that were attacking. Oh man, really insane. So very cool to be here. Good mission so far. Really enjoying the fact that we're here, that we've got artillery, that we've got machine guns, that we've got commanding officers who are ready to be with us in battle. We're going to set up defenses here in town next to this MG as well. We're going to set up, let's see, sandbags too. Our machine gun moving up. I think we can move it, I don't know, somewhere over here into the open field. The Germans will probably attack along the road, but they're not that stupid. They'll probably fan out along the entirety of the farm fields. So we got to be on the lookout for that. All right, we don't have enough time and effort to set everything up that we want to, but here's our boys with the sandbags and such. So we'll set up the sandbags with those individuals, and unlike Men of War Assault Squad, sandbags have to be set up one by one, so it's going to take some time. So we'll put our boys out into the field. Let's go over to this left side, giving us plenty of space to work with the sandbags, and we'll set up a defensive line the best we can. Let's go ahead and start doing this right away. We'll start setting up Belgian defenses here all the way across the road, too. Let's go ahead and start going, boys. There we go. We'll set up defenses the best we can, and we'll block the road as well, and we'll do the same in town. As soon as some of these defenders here are done with setting up their defenses, we'll move over to the other side. We might get some more defenders over on that side. Let's see. We'll probably want to use the fence here. We could probably block them on this flank if they come through. We can lay down on the road too. Set up that MG. Good. We got a minute or less then. Let's go ahead and okay. We'll continue to set up defenses along the roadway. Very good. Let's go ahead and keep it up then. I wonder if there's hotkeys for this. So, by the way, this was all a part of a German plan in World War I to basically cut through Belgium. They thought the Belgians would just stand aside and let them through, but that wasn't the case. All part of a blank plan. Do you remember what that plan was called? Let me know in the comments section, too, by the way. All the German plans, of course, in World War I being used to basically an early blitzkrieg tactic. But, well, as we all know about the trench warfare in World War I guess that wasn't meant to be. So it looks like most of our defenses are set up here. Oh, our guns are here. Excellent. We've got artillery already arriving. Perfect. We've got model 1897s now arriving. Very good to have that technology on our side. Let's keep setting up. Oh, shit. Artillery already? Oh, no. One of our guys being blown out of the guardhouse. I hope they don't hit our artillery, too. We don't have control over it, so we can't stop it. But luckily, our hover horses have arrived. You can see them. By the way, Belgium's having access to some of the hovering technology of World War One. Looks like the feed on that horse wasn't working, I guess. But a horse is a horse, of course. Wow. Good thing we didn't set up our troops over there. Okay, we got lucky with that one. Artillery's still falling on some of our positions. Looks like the Germans are actually already here. The time ran out. We are out of time, baby. All right, let's get some of our troops into defensive positions. Everybody else making sandbags, get back. We're going to go work on town defenses now. Everybody else hit the lines. Defend the barracks at all costs is our new objective. Oh, man. All right, we got to get those guns set up. Let's get our machine guns set up. All of our troops, extra troops. We're going to put everybody on the line. Go, 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 go. Come on, we're out of time. Let's go. Germans got to be here any second now. Lay down, start taking defensive positions. We could take positions in the houses, but we're going to stay out here for the time being until we get some sandbags set up. Oh, here they come. The Germans are finally already here. They are attacking, according to our commander. All right. Well, hopefully we can make sure they don't attack too harsh against us, and we'll try to cut them down wherever they may be. All right. We'll put two men onto a bag at a time, and then we'll start filling them in with a third. Layered defenses here. Two lines of defense here. Very good in town. Not so much. Not so good, Raptor. Bad. Bad Raptor. That's all right. We've got our troops here already ready to set up sandbags, so let's go ahead and start setting those up. Machine gun, yeah, start rocking them. Oh, man, the town's actually on fire there. The little village there already ablaze. Not good. All right, let's keep setting up our defenses here. We'll put up a couple of bags this way just in case the Germans push through. And, yes, it looks like their troops are actually trying to flank through this way as well. All right, we got to stop them. Cut them down, boys. Don't let them through. Don't let them through. All right, we got more reinforcements here. Our Hotchkiss MG there, right next to the road. Another group of Germans just coming up through. Let's get our cannons set up next. Our field artillery set up in the field, as the name would imply. We've still got an entire whole group there of troops, but let's make sure all of our troops here are well defended before we start sending them into battle. I don't want to get hit by artillery again, and I would assume the Germans would probably hit with artillery again first. So these groups, by the way, did last through the entire battle until the Germans bombarded them for 5 days with artillery. That's how harsh the Belgians were on the Germans, and that was a little different case in World War II. They kind of just pushed through right with tanks into France, so it was a little bit different that time. But here in World War I, we don't know about that yet. This is the Great War. So let's go ahead and set up these guns. We're going to need some extra troops over here, I think, to man some of these guns. Apparently Steve's sleeping. Steve, wake up now. It's actually the guy from the guardhouse that got blown across the entirety of the map. Let's set up some more defenses, too. We'll see what else we have for... let's see, sandbags. Well, maybe we can encase our guns or something in sandbags. So we'll set the guns there. We'll push them manually. We do have ammunition here on the roadway as well, but we'll get that set up a little bit later. Looks like most of our guys are set up. There's not much place to hide in the town. Some of our guys are already taking some hits, but we did ambush the enemy. I guess they didn't expect us to be here. They did fire artillery, I suppose, just to try to make sure we kept our heads down, but that's not the case today. The Belgians are ready to rock, holding the defensive line here at the fence. And also here with multiple lines here on the breastwork here that we've set up. Okay, let's go ahead and make sure those field guns are operational. We can, of course, have the guys hop off the horses, but that takes a little too long. We're going to get these field guns set up right away. Canonin D model 1897, a 75mm cannon, according to what we know here, which are armed with both HE and shrapnel shells as well. So let's get those set up right away. We could probably take out entire squads as they're just coming in for battle. Let's set up a further defensive here, and the rest of our guys, I think, are going to have to go to town. We'll leave some of our commanding officers behind for the time being, and we'll continue to reinforce here at the town. There's a house in our way, unfortunately. Maybe we can fight from here. Doesn't look like we can do that. Well, maybe we can flank the enemy. I don't know. We'll send our reinforcements over here, though. They'll have to reinforce Belgian forces there. All right, Belgian forces. Ooh, man, some of our guys get knocked down. Oh, luckily he's still alive. Just a grazing shot or something like that. All right, we got our line set up here. Let's see if we can delete an entire squad as they come in. All right, 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, damn, and it's raining helmets. Oh, my goodness gracious me. That was impressive. They are gone. Goodbye. Wow, bad day to be on the enemy team, I think. Let's go ahead and see if we can hit them over here and get the same effect with our second artillery barrage. Shrapnel shells, man, really causing some impressive damage. That's one thing I really want to see in Battlefield 1, too, is just the effectiveness of artillery to just clear entire sections of infantry like that. Just amazing. Absolutely. An impressively powerful and devastating weapon as well. So let's go ahead and make sure our artillery is pointing in the right direction. I think we can use our artillery sparingly then if we have to, and we'll use it only to thin out the enemy troops. I think we can lay some more troops down around our defensive position here. Let's make sure we got three men on each sandbag, though, and let's make sure it's the same inside town. I'm a little bit more nervous about the town defense, as some of our troops, we may have taken some losses there, but luckily the Germans are kind of getting pinned down by the MG there. Looks like, yeah, we did lose some guys. I don't know. But regardless, if we can take positions up inside the buildings now, luckily they didn't burst into flame or anything from that artillery strike. We'll go ahead and just lay some of our guys down and just try to be in defensive position to reinforce anybody. It's a narrow corridor, and that's probably why the Germans got stooped. Look at that. Our artillery doing a great job of hitting the enemy troops. All right, let's lay some defenders down between these lines here. We'll just try to, wherever we can, turn it into a defensive line and make sure the enemy doesn't cause too much damage to us. All right, we'll go ahead and set that up. All right, they could be much more effective too, by the way, in greater numbers, so that's definitely something we want to use. So the Germans would be just an amazing, formidable force if they're moving so fast. And luckily, you know, we were able to set up our defenses. Without defenses, there's pretty much nothing. You know, it's just basically troops versus troops. They outnumber us, they would win. But here we had a little bit of time to set up some defenses, and looks like they're still trying to push through. Look at that, man. They're trying to flank through the farm fields. Lay down, guys. Yep, some of our boys are being hit. Let's get down now. Carabiners are heavily trained. Another group of Germans coming in there. Our cannons are still unloading on the main forces here. I guess we'll hold here while the town puts up with a little bit more pressure. All right, looks like we've got... Oh, I guess he flew off his horse. That's fine. All right, let's reload some of these guns. The good old-fashioned way, the manual way. So we're going to grab all the ammunition that we can out of it. 75mm HE shells. We'll go ahead and start loading those up. And that's, of course, only for really, I guess, dealing with if we encounter tanks or armored vehicles. And then, of course, if we want to level our own town to clear out enemy positions that they might be hiding behind. But this is kind of the way you have to do it, good old-fashioned way. Or at least I like doing it this way, kind of loading it up one by one. This guy's pretty strong to be able to carry those 75mm shells. All right, let's go ahead and keep dispersing ammo. We'll do HE first, then we'll come back for shrapnel. And there we go, good old-fashioned. If we hit the all button, it'll also distribute some of our other ammunition. We don't want to do that. Some of our other weapons and guns and such. So this should be good to go. All right, there we go. All right, wonderful. We've got everything set up. Horses are horsing around here. All right, still a lot of infantry outside of town here. Let's make sure we level those groups. We seem to be dealing with the ones on the road quite effectively. Our lines are holding for the time being. Belgians are still healing up, but they're not laying down like they should be. They'd like to stand up. I don't know why they're so gangster like that. Our artillery, there we go, leveling those troops there. Inside town, doing a good job. We've still got that MG there. MGs are very effective against these kinds of forces, and we've got two artillery guns, so no wonder the Germans are not having a good day here. They're not having a good day at all. All right, very good. Hotchkiss MG is shooting. All right, let's see. Got plenty of troops here. Everybody's on the line. We could build some more defenses, but I'd rather just lay down. Some of our men here being killed off. Yep, not easy to hold on this side. There was definitely a lot of infantry there pushing through. We've got to be careful. We're not invulnerable, but we are doing a fantastic job against the enemy. Now look at all that artillery is so cool to see there. Both of our guns should be, I think, pointed this direction. Actually, I think that's where they're more likely to bring an armored car if they bring anything like that our way. So we'll keep our guns pointed that way. Meanwhile, at the town, looks like a couple of defenders being wounded there as well. Blood everywhere, pretty much. And we could probably flank the enemy. Let's see if we can get into a flanking position. Over here, I guess, at this house, we could flank. And let's see if we can get into another defensive position somewhere where we can stop the enemy from pushing forward. Looks like they're cutting across the farm field again. And more enemy infantry reinforcements. Wow, we seem to be doing quite a number against the Germans. All right, let's go ahead and make sure we're facing the right way. Oh, lay down. No grenades here. Just good old-fashioned. Let's fire off as one of these riflemen then. Let's take control of a Belgian rifleman. See if we can score some hits on the enemy. All right, I don't know who's alive and who's dead. They're all pinned down, though. An insane amount of rifle fire and MG fire and cannons firing off here. Look at that defensive position. That is incredible. That just really looks amazing. Germans still trying to push through. You see a German officer there. Germans are pinned down in the farm fields. More reinforcements being ordered to push through. And just an insane amount of losses that the Germans took. A gun flying off to the moon there. Oh my goodness. All right, a good position here. Come get some, baby. Yes, come and have some, as they would say in World War One. We've only got one machine gunner left on this, so they did hit us. Does anybody see that guy? Oh, get wrecked. Oh, are we out of MG ammo? Oh, we are out. Okay, the MG's out. Wow, did a fantastic job of holding. I'll abandon that gun now. Hop up into one of the windows or something like that and start shooting. We're out of MG. We're going to be pushed back. Look at all the German losses here. That is absolutely... look at that. That is just like an execution wall. That is insane. They're still pushing through. Buildings are actually on fire now. Germans have lit some of the buildings on fire. I hope we don't have any defenders in there. I can't see anybody up in those windows, but my God. What do they got coming in down here? Oh, enemy artillery coming in. Oh, let's hit them with shrapnel shells. Maybe we can capture those guns. German artillery trying to be set up now. I don't think so. Not today. Let's hit them right here. Oh, nice. One gun immediately decrewed. We can actually run up there and grab those with our hurt. Oh, we're going to add some hurt with some horses. Woo! Oh, sorry about that. Didn't mean to hit you right in the gun port. Oh, they're going to fire soon. Don't you fire. Oh, no. They're firing back at us. Oh, no. And they destroyed one of our guns. Oh, those jerks. Oh, we're going to capture your gun back then. Germans brought their own field artillery. Man, is that thing firing fast. Both of our guns just insta-act by the Germans. Well, we have no other choice. We're going to go up there and take those German artillery then instead. Let's, no horsing around. Let's double time it. Germans are going to batter our position a little bit now. This is going to look really epic. A lot of our troops are going to be pushed back and really experience some devastation now. We're going to just go right up there and capture that gun then. Oh, they're, okay, zigzag, zigzag. They're onto us. Not today, Germans. Our hover horses are here. All right, pop those guys. Oh shit, did he kill one of our horses? I think he might have, that bastard. German artillery has been neutralized. Let's grab one of these guns. We'll send another horse up then. Hopefully we've got another guy standing around. We'll grab this other gun. All right, German artillery. We got you. GTA on that. Look, they destroyed our own guns. Now we got some, we got some more full guns now. Wow, German artillery, very devastating. But now we've completely stolen their own guns. That's got to be real embarrassing for the Germans. Really a great thing. Luckily for us, it looks like we were able to stop that artillery as soon as we could. They insta-act on both of our guns. That's impressive. I'm glad we didn't destroy their guns instead. Then we've captured their own. That's good news. All right, let's get off the horse and start getting on the German gun. So the German gun, 77mm FK-96. And that is probably armed with the same, both HE and shrapnel rounds as well. Yeah, unfortunately, we don't have ammunition for this, but we've got them fully loaded. So let's grab this artillery gun as well. And, oh, we already were hooked up to it. Let's come on back with that other horse. So very good. Innovation of war to steal enemy equipment like that. I don't think we can actually repair any of our own equipment. Looks like it's been completely destroyed, unfortunately. So we'll keep our defensive positions up. Looks like they did hit some of our defensive positions and some of our defenses eliminated, but not a lot of men killed, if any. So we're real lucky about that one. All right, let's continue on then. One German gun already armed. Let's go ahead and delete a squad then with the Kaiser's own weapon. Goodbye. Look at the blast on that, man. Just a couple of extra millimeters on that makes all the difference. Huge explosions from that FK. Let's go down here. We'll set up a defense on the road then with this other gun. We seem to have drained the enemy of a lot of power. Look at the absolute devastation here. Look at the amount of forces that are just pinned down. Oh, I think they did get our other MG too. So they actually, well, look at that. With their artillery shells, they may have landed like two or three rounds each gun, and all of our artillery and ammunition all destroyed like that. So they did a really good job of just kind of sneaking in and trying to set up their weapons. And well, luckily we were able to stop them. Let's get this other gun up and operational. We'll flip it over onto that side of the town. Maybe we can turn this other gun actually to hit some of the troops just outside of town, and maybe we can level the town a little bit. We want to kind of try to maybe limit the damage that the Germans are causing inside town. So let's go ahead and do a surgical strike, World War One style. Oops, didn't mean to level the fence there. I thought this would fire up and over, not like direct, but let's go ahead and give it another shot. There we go. Wow, did you see that nuclear blast? Like, it just took out that entire cabbage patch. Just goodbye. All right, let's fire again. Oh, look at that. That round, I think that round actually hit inside of a soldier and, like, his body absorbed most of the blast. That was incredible. There we go. That's the end of that. All right, most of those Germans finished off there. More Germans coming in. We're still getting pushed back. Some of our defenses are down. I'm not going to rebuild anymore now. We're going to just see how it plays out. We're going to try to see. This is how the trenches of World War One kind of started too, by the way. You can see all the craters and such being dug. You know, obviously you could dig between these, the artillery digging out the initial hole, and then if you connect these, suddenly you got positions to fire at the enemy on, and that's kind of how that whole trench warfare may have began. I'm not exactly sure, but that's my theory. What's yours? I don't know. I'm sure there's an actual designation for it, but since I don't know, I'll make up history. Looks like we did have one soldier here that possibly died from fire inside the building. He looks pretty burned up. He must have been up in one of the windows, so good thing we didn't put all of our troops up there. That's good. And looks like the enemy's still continuously trying to flank around. We do have MGs and such at base. We have Lewis gunners and such as well. And so we'll set up the rest of these guys over here. And we still got our artillery gun there. HE ready to fire. Let's see how HE fares against the enemy. I don't know if we actually seen that yet. Let's go ahead and fire off a shell right here. High explosive. Wow, that's what makes the that's what makes the hit. Shrapnel for infantry, but high explosive really to devastate defensive positions. And let's try this again. Put a little crater in the road. That was sweet to see that come right by our camera. All but one man eliminated and heavily wounded. Oh, wow. Incredible. The rest of our guys here are attending to Brian. We're still trying to figure out what to do. Brian is asleep. We're going to actually try to have a meeting about this. Perhaps we could look at him with our binoculars a little bit and see what's going on inside Brian's head. No? Okay. Let's see what he's got. Got a couple of bandages and such. So one thing that's great about this game too is that you can always, as you saw earlier with the inventory being reloaded from the artillery, you can always utilize that against friend or foe. So you can always take ammunitions and weapons and such like that and really have some good times. All right, looks like the enemy's gathered around this house. Let's level this house with our 77 millimeters and see what we can do here. Let's go ahead and load both HE if we can. Let's just level this house and see how it goes out. Look at that, man. Enemies using that as a defensive position. We gotta get rid of it. Sorry about that, Belgian homeowners, but sorry. Look at that, man. Belgian homes. Wow, they built those. Watch out, IKEA, the Belgians. Look at that. Three artillery hits and finally took it down. All right, that's their cover eliminated. All of our guys on the fence now. Really have an open shot on all these guys. Let's open up fire here. Get on that fence line, boys. Get to the defense. Oh. Open up with that Lewis gun. Are you out of ammo? Oh, wow. Lewis gunner out of ammo. The Belgians here. I don't think there's any way to replenish that unless we literally go back to base and do it by hand, but I'm not going to be messing around with all that. Still some losses taken over here. Artillery again destroying our defensive position and our artillery here, so we didn't get off scot-free. You could just simply imagine this on some of the higher difficulties. Wow, just made for pros, and that's definitely not me. I'm a noob and I shock. But I have a good time, and that's where I win. All right, let's hit him more with some more heavy artillery. Let's see what happens. Not as effective as the shrapnel rounds, I'd say. The shrapnel rounds, though ineffective against anything aside from a living organic creature, still you want to use HE against vehicles. And it has a wider radius, I think. You can see the blast radius on that. It seems like we killed a lot more men, but maybe that's just because they were coming in. Look at this, man. The Germans just throwing over 100,000 men into the battle. You can see why it was so one-sided. Guns just being thrown up into the air, violently tossed aside. That's incredible. Wow, and we've still got a lot of our troops still in their defensive positions. Let's get make sure we've got all of our guys on the sandbags. So yeah, you really need some extra time to prepare your defenses. You're being attacked from the industrial sector of town, I guess, from the farm fields, side roads, and the Germans even bringing some artillery out to the logging area where I guess they set up two of those large 77mm guns, and not something that you want to be on the other side of, especially if it's your own stolen gun, still devastating most of your men. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. All right, it looks like we might be taking some losses over here. This guy, I don't even think this guy has a gun. Get in that trench then, man. All right, we'll still put some more men on this line here. We don't really have a line. I don't know why he keeps wanting to fight like that. He keeps like, all right, whatever. Go on the line then. This guy's got a mind of his own. He keeps trying to pick up his own gun, but defend the barracks at all costs has been completed. We defended Liege today, but they will attack us again tomorrow. So almost 1,000 enemy losses, 20 men, and 12 vehicles on our side. What? 12 vehicles? Oh, I suppose if you count up, vehicles are probably considered to be the ammo wagons and the machine guns as well that were hit by artillery, plus any of the gun. There was a guard tower, for example, here that had a machine gun in it as well that we could man, but the enemy probably not going to attack it from that position, but you can see here the barracks command position destroyed. Looks like possible artillery strike here on the fuel area, and we also had a supply truck and so much more here as well to work with, but we did hold the barracks as our orders Why is our orders ordered? So, anyway, a fantastic mod, a fantastic mission. Thank you very much for joining me, and until next time, a Circle 7 to you, and I will see you very soon. Bye.